Heavenly Father, we get to sing and praise you. We get to be here because you are our God, our Lord, our Savior, our best friend. We get to be here, Lord, as a community of faith, trust, journeying to know you more, to go deeper into a relationship with you. That is what you desire for us, to be in a relationship with you. And so, Lord, bless us in the hearing of your word, because in the hearing of your word, our faith grows. In your name we pray. Amen. You may be seated. For those of you who may have just seen me hand off my hymnal, I just remind you that this is an altar, and so I don't use it as a place to rest things. This is the altar of the Lord, so this is what needs to be there. So I handed off my hymnal, my prayer page to Bob, because the plants are here, so I couldn't put it down. Okay, so the topic for today, well, anyway, the series is Let's Get Going. Okay, let's get going, because we've had a kind of a rough start to this year of 2017 with snowstorms and illnesses and the cancellation of the cantata because of illness in some of the solo parts. And so let's get going in this journey of faith. And so we're talking about the star-led journey of faith, and that the Magi brought gifts to the Lord, the newborn king, and that then we talked about that we need to fix our eyes on Jesus. We need to just have a laser focus on Jesus. And now today I want to talk a little bit about what faith is all about. You know, you can't do it in a 15-minute sermon here, but what I want to talk about is that about believing, faith and believing. We believe, and there's no doubt about that. That's why we're here. You're here because you believe, or are struggling with belief, or thinking about believing. Maybe there's one or two of you who are not sure, and you're here just to see what's going on. Yet, sometimes it is difficult to maintain that belief, isn't it? And that's why the story of the father and the son. Do you believe? Well, yes, Lord, I believe, but help my unbelief. Help me when I just don't trust that I believe. And so many of us are like that, right? And the challenge for us is to maintain our belief in times of doubt and fear, and in times of confusion and change, and in times of illness and addiction. To, in all circumstances of our lives, to maintain a belief in God and who he is and what he says he will do. It's when we are facing a marriage that is disintegrating before our eyes, the challenge is to have faith. When we are watching a loved one gasping for breath, we are challenged to have faith, to go deeper in our faith. When in times of desperation, when we look all around us and all we see is a broken generation, when all we see, when we look to the world, we see the beheadings of Christians in the Middle East and the killing of Syrians, Syrian civilians, and the destruction of history, of buildings of history, wantonly. Or when we look around the world and we see abject poverty in places like Haiti, or the hungry and swollen bellies of babies and children and mothers and families throughout Africa and the drought areas of Africa. There is only one salvation. There is only one salvation, Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior. There is only one salvation for this dark world, for the broken world, for a broken generation, and that is Jesus Christ, our Lord and our Savior, the one who entered time and history, who was born in a manger, the one who placed the stars in the heavens and created the planets, the one who came into the world, God incarnate, God made man, God, to bring light into the darkness of this world set against itself. And so the foundation of Christian living is faith in Christ Jesus. So let's get going. Let's get going. Let's get a grip on faith. That's the title of this sermon. Let's get a grip on faith. And so sometimes we feel like we are walking on thin air. And if we look down, we will end up like Wile E. Coyote from The Roadrunner. When we look down, if we don't see the foundation and we don't trust the foundation of Jesus Christ, we are just like Wile E. Coyote or running off that cliff being chased by the roadrunner, being chased by life. And we run off the cliff and we can easily wind up like Wile E. Coyote splattered on the ground. As Christians, though, on the journey of faith, faith is the solid foundation, isn't it? It's the bedrock for life as a Christian. And so today, we are tempted to put our faith in many things. We are tempted to put our faith in the gurus on TV that tell us how to live our lives and all those infomercials. Boy, they're getting wild, huh? And we place our trust and our belief in money and friends and technology and astrology, and to put our belief and our trust in ourselves and or military power or political leaders or the experts and all the self-help books that we see. Excuse me. Scripture urges us to trust in the Lord with all your heart and lean not on your own understanding. That's from Scripture. Remember that. Trust in the Lord with all your heart and lean not on your own understanding. Proverbs chapter 3. However, believing in God is quite a bit easier than believing God. Believing in God is quite a bit easier than believing God. Believing that God has done what he says he has done, trusting the Bible, believing in the story. Believing in the story of God and believing that we are part of that story of God. Faith in God means that we rely on him and depend upon his reliability. So hear that again. We rely on him and depend upon his reliability. Faith does not depend on you or me. Faith does not depend upon circumstances. Faith does not depend upon outcomes. Faith does not depend upon whether it's even true or not. Faith depends on the object of our faith. And what is the object of our faith? Or who is the object of our faith? Our God. God the Father, God the Son, God the Holy Spirit. From Hebrews 11. Now, faith is confidence in what we hope for and the assurance about what we do not see. Faith is the assurance, the confirmation of things hoped for, the divine things that we hope for, that are guaranteed to us. Faith is the assurance, the confirmation of things that are divinely guaranteed to us by God. And the evidence, faith is the evidence of things that we cannot see. The conviction that they are real. Faith, in other words, comprehends as fact. Faith comprehends as fact what cannot be experienced by our physical senses. It's the spiritual realm. Faith comprehends the spiritual realm that we trust in, that we believe in, that is reality. And so it takes faith to believe in God the Father, the author and the source of all of life. It takes faith to believe in the Father who created you and me. It takes faith to believe in God the Son, the one who came in the manger of Bethlehem, the one who went to the cross and was crucified, the one who received the nail blows in the hands and feet. It takes faith to believe in the resurrection. And it takes faith to believe in the Holy Spirit, the Spirit alive within us, God's presence in us. It takes faith. That's the heavenly realm. That's the divine realm that we believe in, that we trust in. It takes faith to believe that there is a loving God who is passionate about you and me. It takes faith to believe that there is a God who accepts you and me just as we are, with all our messy lives. It takes faith to believe that there is a God who forgives you and me, who forgives us as we rebel against him, as we go our own way, as we live and speak in harmful and hurtful ways. It takes faith to believe in a God who cares deeply about your pain and my pain. It takes faith to believe in life after death. Woody Allen says, I am not afraid of death. I just don't want to be there when it happens. Having faith means realizing and accepting that God is bigger, greater, better, wiser than you and I could ever be. And that he certainly is greater than the power of Satan, the devil, and all his empty promises. From Scripture, 1 John, he who is in you, God, is greater than he who is in the world, Satan. God who is in you is greater than Satan who is in the world. And so it takes faith. Faith is a gift that God gives us. If we're asking, and that faith comes at the waters of holy baptism, when we're washed with the power of the Holy Spirit. So if you are asking, how do I begin the journey of faith, then I say to you, you already have begun, because you're already asking. The Spirit of God, the Holy Spirit, is moving your heart and your mind to look around and seek to know God. In fact, it is the power of the Holy Spirit stirred up in you at the waters of holy baptism that go with you in life's journey, and that empowers you in the journey of faith. And if you're already on the journey of faith, like so many of us are, that's why you're here, that's why you're worshiping, the Holy Spirit is continually nudging you and me to respond in faith to all that life throws at us, to respond in faith to all that life hits us with, the good, the bad, the ugly, and to continually to seek and know and go deeper in the journey of faith in our relationship with our God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. And so we increase our faith by hearing his word, says Scripture, by hearing, by studying, by memorizing, by coming to worship and hearing the word spoken and read concerning the message of Jesus Christ. That's how faith grows. Faith is where our relationship with God begins. Because Scripture says, without faith, it is impossible to please God. Why does Why is it impossible to please God without faith? Because that means you don't believe in him. You don't trust him, you know, you just walk away from him by faith. Without faith, it is impossible to please God. So remember, everything the Lord has for us, and everything he does for us, is accessed by faith. Most people who are on the journey of faith don't doubt that faith works. Most people on a journey of faith don't doubt that faith works, but we doubt whether we have enough faith to get through, to persevere, to push through the difficulties and the circumstances. And so, like the Father today in the gospel, again, Lord, I believe. I do believe, but help my unbelief. I'm not always trusting. I don't have enough faith. And Jesus says, you have enough. Here, your son is healed. And so often like the Father, we're wondering, as we struggle, as we face our problems and our difficulties. And so if Satan can blind you and me to the truth that you have enough faith and more, because God promises more than we could ever hope for or imagine, says Scripture. If Satan can blind you and me that to the fact that we don't have enough faith, then he will keep you and me from using the faith that we have and accessing the power, the wisdom, the guidance of what and who we believe in. God the Father, God the Son, God the Holy Spirit.
All we know is doubt and fear.
Lord, we believe. Help our unbelief. We believe in you. We believe in all that you have given us. We believe in you, God the Father, creator of heaven and earth, and we believe in you, Jesus Christ, who is the one who came and born in the manger, who suffered under Pontius Pilate, beaten, bloody, brought to be crucified, died and was buried, descended into hell, broke the chains of sin and death, and on the third day he rose again. You, Jesus, ascended into heaven, and you sit at the right hand of our Father. And we know that you will come again. But in the meantime, in this broken generation, this broken life, the life battered and bruised, we believe in the Holy Spirit who has come to be with us, to guide us and show us the way. We believe in your holy church, church united under the banner of the cross. Differences abound, but the cross is what unites us. And we believe in the community of all Christians together. And we believe in the forgiveness of sin. And we believe in the resurrection. And we believe in life everlasting. Heavenly Father, we come to you, trusting in who you are and what you are about. For it is written in Scripture. It has been told by generation upon generation, the story of who you are. And we are part of that story as we live out our lives, challenged by faith, challenged by the struggles and the pains and the difficulties of this broken world, challenged to live honoring you. Heavenly Father, as we come to you today, we pray for those who are struggling in their journey of faith, who do not know you. And so we pray for Allison and Trish and Donna and Paul and John, Mark and John and Jane, for Robert and Stephen and Megan and Ken and Keith and Daniel struggling with drugs, and Todd struggling with